Hi everyone, come back to my channel because this is Dr. Spinach. This is the fifth video in the series of pharmacokinetics on drug excretion. If you recall, we have already discussed about drug absorption, distribution of drug into different body parts, metabolism of drug so that it can be converted into a suitable metabolite that can be excreted out of the system. The elimination of the drug is the most important part of all. This is because accumulation of any drug will cause toxicity in the body.
So, what is excretion? How does it occur? And what are the routes through which drug can excrete out of the body?
Think about these questions. Okay, well, I'm sure at least two routes of excretion came up into your mind. That is through urine and through feces. Congratulations, very well done. Now, let's begin with our first question on definition of excretion. Excretion is defined as the passage out of a systemically absorbed drug. That means the drug is said to be excreted when it is first absorbed in the blood and then eliminates out through various different routes from the body.
Dr. Spinach, what are the various routes of drug elimination?
First most important one is via kidney as urine. There are some prerequisites for the drug to be excreted via kidney. If a drug is getting excreted into urine, the drug should be A. water-soluble and B. polar. Now, if you remember my previous tutorial on metabolism, I mentioned that our liver modifies the drug into a metabolite which is both water-soluble and polar, so that it can be easily excreted out of the body via urine. Moving forward with our next route of drug elimination, that is via bile as feces. This can be achieved through hepatobiliary system. Drug after metabolism in the liver is excreted into bile and via bile into the feces. This is, however, a minor part of the drug. The major part of the drug is absorbed back into the bloodstream from the gut and is excreted out via kidney. The drugs that attain high concentrations in bile include erythromycin, ampicillin, rifampin, tetracycline, oral contraceptives, and vecuronium. The first four of which are antibiotics, but the rifampicin is selectively used to treat tuberculosis. The third way the drugs are excreted out is via lungs as exhaled air. These drugs should be in the form of gases or highly volatile liquids. The examples include general anesthetics and alcohol. And this is the reason why your breath stinks after alcohol consumption.
Oh, whoa!
Also, alcohol breath test is used by the traffic police to test drunk driving. Another elimination route is through sweat and saliva. These are actually of very less importance for drug excretion. This is because most of the saliva, along with the drug in it, is swallowed and meets the same fate as orally taken drug. Lithium, which is used in maniac disorders, potassium iodide, rifampicin, which is again an antitubercular drug, and heavy metals, usually due to poisoning, are present in these secretions. The fifth elimination route is via mother's milk. The excretion of drug in the milk is not important for the mother, but for the infant who receives the milk. Most drugs enter breast milk by passive diffusion. Therefore, a drug must be highly lipid-soluble and less protein-bound in order to be expressed in mother's milk. So, that is it. So, what are the routes of excretion we saw so far? The first one is as urine via kidney. The second one is as feces via bile, as exhaled air via lungs, as sweat and saliva, and as milk. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss in details about the drug excretion via kidney. Nephron is the fundamental unit of kidney. There are three major functions of the kidney. That is glomerular filtration, in which all the non-protein bound drug is filtered from the glomerulus into the Bowman's capsule. Tubular reabsorption, in which the drug is absorbed back into the blood vessel. and tubular secretion, in which the drug present in the blood vessel is secreted into the tubules so that it can be excreted out via urine. Fourth, the net renal excretion equals glomerular filtration plus tubular secretion minus tubular reabsorption. Because the drug is absorbed back into the blood vessel and is systemically available for action. Now, let's understand some of the important parameters used in excretion. Now, let's say CP is the concentration of drug in plasma, CU is the concentration of drug in urine, and VU is the rate at which urine is produced. Therefore, the clearance will be equal to the concentration of drug in urine multiply by the rate at which urine is produced divided by the concentration of drug in plasma.
Okay, well, what does it actually mean?
It means if there is a certain amount of drug in plasma, how quickly can our body get rid of it? The concentration of drug in plasma will therefore depend upon the dose of the drug. If you increase the dose, the concentration of the drug will thereby increase in the plasma. The rate at which urine is produced will depend upon the rate at which plasma is filtered into the renal tubules, that is, the glomerular filtration rate. Therefore, in a kidney disease, if the GFR decreases, the rate at which urine is produced is also decreased, thereby decreasing the clearance of the drug. Therefore, we need to adjust the drug dosage because they will not get rid of the drug as quickly as someone with normal kidneys. Now, let's look at different things that can happen to the drug in the nephron. If the filtration is increased, that means the clearance will increase. If the reabsorption is increased, that means the drug goes back into the blood vessel, the clearance decreases. If the secretion is increased, that means the drug goes into the renal tubule and out through the urine, the clearance will increase. Or if a drug has a property of getting reabsorbed more, it will have less clearance. If a drug has a property of getting secreted more, it will have more clearance. The example of a drug that is secreted more is penicillin.
Wait, is that it?
Yes, that is it. That is all on drug excretion. In the next video, I'm going to discuss about order of kinetics. So stay tuned for the next episode on Pharmacology with Dr. Spinach. Thank you very much for listening to me. Please like, subscribe and share. Click on the notification bell down below so that you can get the updates as soon as I post the latest videos. Until then, keep safe and keep healthy.